All right, I'm just going to cut to the chase here and just start off by saying this is probably one of my favorite movies of 2019. It's not a big blockbuster film. It's not Avengers or Spider-Man or Hobbs and Shaw. It's a very personal yet a message in this film that speaks to everyone. It's universal. Coming out August 16th, everyone please go see it, Blinded by the Light. Hey guys, thank you for coming by. I am so glad I finally had a chance to see this film. I saw it last Wednesday, and there were a lot of advanced screenings for this movie for months, and I'm just glad I finally had one playing near me. It comes out worldwide this coming Friday, but this is a film that I feel speaks so much in regards to inspiring others, and I love films like that. And I know many others that are probably watching this video may have seen it already, so tell me in the comments below, what did you think of this film? If you haven't even heard of it, please, I recommend seeing it this weekend. And don't forget, consider clicking on that subscribe button and the bell in order to hear any more content from me for your future enjoyment. I'll probably mispronounce some of these names, so I apologize in advance for not being able to say them correctly. But first, a quick breakdown of the movie. Blinded by the Light is a British comedy drama film directed by Gurinder Chadha and inspired by the life of journalist Safraz Manzoor and his love of songs by Bruce Springsteen. Set in the town of London in 1987 Britain, the film tells the coming-of-age story of Javed, a British Pakistani Muslim teenager whose life is changed after he discovers the music of Bruce Springsteen. Vivek Kalvari stars in the lead role along with Hayley Atwell, Brian Brendan, and Neil Williams in supporting roles. I don't have a script made for this one. I'm just going to say exactly what I feel about this movie. It's nothing but praise because, as I said before, the themes of it is exactly the type of movie that I feel everyone can relate to. And it just inspires me to really say what I feel in my heart about this film. And I don't need something to memorize to really convey that to you guys. I can tell you how great the acting was. I can tell you how great the score was, the music by Bruce Springsteen, and the writing was great, which is, that's what the bulk of this film is all about, is in that writing and the dialogues between the characters. But really, what it centers around is the main character of Javed, and he really symbolizes everyone in the end. He is from Pakistan, he's a Muslim, his family is now living in England, in Britain, and they're at a time when they're rejected from the rest of the community there. And he has this type of position where he can't really go after his dreams because of those limitations. And then he also has his father, which is still living in that type of conventional family where everything goes by what he says, and he does not want his son to be something like a writer, which is what Javed's main purpose in his life, what he wants it to be. He wants to go and be a writer. He loves doing nothing but that. And his teacher, played by Hayley Atwell, really encourages him to do that. But the father wants him just to get an education, get a job, and just do what you're meant to do, and that is everything for the family, and just push those dreams to the side. The reason why I say everyone can relate to this is because we all have a dream. We all have something that we want to do in life, but sometimes there's always someone or something holding us back from doing it. And if we don't keep making that seed grow with the things that we really want to do in life, it's never going to get any better. For example, me on YouTube, I started about 5 months ago, and I really didn't think I was that good at it, and I'm still not that great at it, but I'm getting there. And the more you do something, the better you will get at it, and that's exactly what happens in this film. He's writing, he thinks his writing is absolutely horrible, and once he listens to the music of Bruce Springsteen, and with a little help of from his teacher, he's able to really make those dreams in his head become bigger than what he thought they would ever be. And even though I said everything's inspirational with this movie, it's also whimsical, it's fun. There are a lot of laughs in this film, but there's a perfect balance with this movie between it being a drama with the situations that he faces with his family and the turmoil of the civil rights that the family has and the Muslims of that community have, along with him trying to pursue what he wants to do, and then the mixture of music that he first gets introduced to. And that's another thing about this film. If you don't know who Bruce Springsteen is, it doesn't matter. I mean, everyone knows who he is, but you can still not know his music. I'm actually familiar with only maybe a small handful of his songs, but I know who the guy is. But even the music in this film, when he's listening to it, you really get in there with him and you can feel what he's feeling. And the scenes where he's first hearing the songs, they did a really smart thing of having the words go across the screen as he's hearing them, just so we're able to see exactly what Bruce is saying and it connects to this character so well. And that's why he feels that Bruce, this guy that lives on the other side of the world, is actually speaking to him. And that's one of the reasons I feel it inspires him. And later on, he goes on to say that someone like Bruce and him have actually had almost the same life. Another thing to prove that with someone like Bruce Springsteen, Javed, he can go after his dreams and be just as successful. I just found myself with a smile on my face watching this whole movie, and it wasn't because of like the comedy or anything like that. It was because of our central character, Javed, how he was able to escape the traps of being in this family where he felt like he couldn't go any further with what he wanted to do, and also within the community, how everyone was against their kind of people. And he was able to find this other world through Bruce Springsteen's music. And you can see that he felt free. He felt like he had some door, some way out of there to really go after what he wanted. And you just felt like you were with him on that journey the entire way. I can go on and on with why I like this movie, and I don't want to do that because I'll probably keep repeating myself. But really, guys, go see this film. You always hear critics say it's the feel-good movie of the year, it's the movie of the year. And I think they mean it when they see something like this. If I was a critic, I really would use that cliched phrase of this is the feel-good movie of the year. But you all already know what my rating is for this film. You knew from the very beginning of this video, it's a 10 out of 10. Just, I'll say it again, go see it, please. It's exactly what I needed watching this movie. It's probably what a lot of other people need, especially with the time that we're living in. And we just need a little bit of light, and ironically enough, Blinded by the Light. Perfect title. But I hope you all enjoyed my nonstop praise about this movie. It really does deserve it. I just hope I can encourage others to check out this film if you haven't seen it yet. It's really a movie, as I said before, that I needed to see, and I hope others as well, because it's universal. It's something that we all can benefit from, going after something we want to do, and it just really shows the struggles of where the road can take you, but how successful it can be in the end as long as you don't stop doing it. But as always, don't forget to give it a like if you enjoyed my thoughts, and don't forget to subscribe to hear anything regarding movies, TV shows, and more. Y'all have a great day. I'll see you later.